Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Neff, and today I'm going to show you how to automate the process of capturing form responses and then injecting that data into a Google Doc template, and then from there, save it as a PDF. This is super useful for creating automated reports, invoices, or any other kind of document you need to generate dynamically. All right, let's get started. All right, so the first thing that we want to do is create our Google form, and we're going to do this in a little bit different way. First, we're going to do it through Google Sheet. So create a Google Sheet, and a handy little shortcut that might be useful to you is to type in sheets.new in the URL bar, and then that'll automatically create a new sheet for you. So thought you might find that helpful. Going back to my original Google Sheet that I'm going to be using for this video, what you can do is go over to Tools and then create a new form from here. So that's going to create a new form and it's going to link it to your Google Sheet. So then head over to your Google form. Mine looks like this. And something that I want to point out here that I think is pretty cool is that you can add different fields and it'll automatically append to the Google Sheet. So let me show you what that looks like. So if I go back to Google Sheets and then manage the form, I want to edit it. So then from here, for example, if I wanted to create a new one, a new field, let's call this just number. And then going back to our Google Sheet, you'll notice that column G appended a column header called number. So that's pretty cool. One little caveat is that if you decide to just eliminate this new form field, it's not going to remove it from Google Sheets. So let's say we remove it, we go back to Google Sheet, it's just going to stay there. So just remember to remove that. One other thing that I want to point out here is that when you create a brand new Google Sheet, it'll automatically be called Sheet 1, right? So your worksheet is going to be called Sheet 1 out of the gate. When you create your Google form, you'll notice that there's a new worksheet and it's going to be called whatever the title of your form is called. So what you want to do is make sure that the sheet name is consistent with your Google Apps script because it's going to be referring to it. So I'll touch on that in just a little bit. And you can actually see here, I call this one custom data, and I just appended that underscore zero because I just didn't need it anymore. In fact, I'm just going to hide it so it just doesn't confuse or cause any confusion. All right, so we have our Google form set up. We have our worksheets set up. They're cleaned up. They're named the way that we want them to. So the next thing that we're gonna look at is setting up our Google Apps script. So to set it up, make sure that it's linked to your Google Sheet. So an easy way to do that is to head over to Extensions and then select Apps Script. From there, your next step is to pretty much copy and paste this into the editor and then just update a couple of fields. So remember how I said that you want to have your worksheet name consistent with your Google Apps script? Well, this is the line that I'm talking about because this line is getting the sheet by name and it has to be identical to what we have in our Google Sheet, which is down here. So it's called custom data or customer data. So this says customer data as well. So we're good there. And then what you want to do next is replace your Google Doc template ID and also the Google Drive folder ID. So that's done right here. And to get that ID, what you need to do is head over to your Google Doc template ID and then just grab this text string right after that D forward slash and then paste it into your Google Apps script. And then also for your folder, it'll be after the folders forward slash. So it's pretty much the end of your URL. So that takes care of the script. Now, in order to run it, we need to set up a trigger. And the trigger that we want to execute the script is on form submission. So whenever someone is done submitting the form, like we see here, we want to execute that script because we then want to generate that doc to insert the data from the Google Sheet and then convert it into a PDF. So going back to Apps Script, head over to Triggers, and then what we want to do is execute the Generate PDF function. So that's the function that we're going to select here. And then keep this at head to run at deployment. We're going to select from spreadsheet for the event source and then on form submit as the event type. And if you want, you can set up your failure notifications immediately is my preference. Go ahead and save that. And next, let's test out the script to make sure everything is working properly. So I'm going to go to the Google form. I'm going to put in my name, some fictitious data, and then let's click on submit. So if we head over to our Google Sheet, we can see that it got appended at the very end. So I removed some of this data here, so that's why you see a huge gap. So next, let's go over to our Google Drive. So it's going to be saved in that folder ID that I put into the app script. So this is the folder. And then if I click on this one, so this one just ran, right, 348. Let's open that up. And you can see that the document is a PDF and that data from Google Sheets got inserted into that template doc, this Google Doc template. And you can see the little curly braces is where that data got injected. So if I wanted to add more information or expand on my form, I would have to create these curly braces. And then also a special note here is that the naming convention needs to match exactly how you see it in your Google Sheet. So if it doesn't, it's just the script isn't going to understand to grab the information from the Google Sheet and then inject it into that placeholder because it just doesn't exist. All right, so that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. And if you have any questions or if you have any comments on any future videos you'd like to see, I'd love to hear from you. And until then, I'll see you in the next one.